Out of everything in my home, I have one spot that's my favorite, and it's a sign right above our back door that says gratitude turns what you have into enough. My name's Joe Moffitt with Master Life by Design, and today I want to teach you how to be grateful and why in three simple steps. So what is gratitude? Gratitude's simply an emotion. I think we all know that, right? One out of, you know, thousands of emotions that we can experience in our body. And all an emotion is energy, right? It's a frequency. If we were to measure that energy, it would have a certain frequency to it. Now, there's a whole chart from low vibration states to high vibration states. And where do you think gratitude falls on that? You probably guess right. It's on the higher end, right? It's a higher frequency. And what I love about gratitude is you actually, when you experience true gratitude, you feel more rich, you feel more loving, you feel more kind. I'm gonna share with you some benefits of it here in a little bit, but I will tell you, I have a completely different day when I'm at that higher vibration of gratitude. Now, here's what you need to know. Most people are like, man, I wish I could live in gratitude every day, all day long. Well, that's great, but our physiology can only take so much of one emotion, and it has to shift, right? It's just physiologically, we can't live there. And that's the beauty of life, because I wouldn't want to live in just gratitude, because I love being curious. I love being adventurous. I would miss out on the happiness and excitement moments, right? Like, there's so many rich emotions out there. Gratitude is one of many in your toolbox that you want to pull from and experience, but it's extremely powerful, and we'll talk about why here in a little bit. So what's the first step to experience gratitude? The first step is you have to slow down. So many people are just so busy in their life, they never slow down. You have to slow down to really experience that state of gratitude. Now, look, I know people say, well, I've been on the go and I've been grateful for the things that have happened in my life. And I agree, I've been there too. You know, I watched my Eagles win the Super Bowl in 2018, and I was extremely grateful in the moment that I had so much going on, right? However, that doesn't always happen. Right? And I'm not talking about just the Eagles winning the Super Bowl. That doesn't always happen though. Usually it's when we slow down and we really get in touch with ourselves, we get in that present moment, that we could truly experience that state of gratitude, or at least magnify that experience. And that's the challenge with a lot of people, is they don't slow down enough. They don't get so present that they can actually tap into this state. Because it would shock you how many clients I come and I work with. And one of the things we do is in the beginning of our calls, we'll work on celebrations. But I may ask, you know, what's one thing you're truly grateful for and why? Because then they can tap into that state. But sometimes I get clients that say, I really can't experience gratitude. I don't know why I can't. And one of the reasons that I've discovered over the years after working on, you know, 16,000 coaching calls is that people don't slow down enough. It's until you can get calm and lower your heart rate and just get present is when you're able to experience gratitude, or at least magnify that experience. So that's the first one. The second thing is you have to use contrast. This is the key. I saved it for the best, for the middle here, because I want you to know that contrast is one of those ways that when we don't feel like it, you just can't seem to get into that state of gratitude. Like, oh, I want to be grateful for my family. And you're just like, oh, I can't feel it. The reason being is we may need to use contrast to be able to do that. For example, I know there's times where my son, he's 2 years old, 2.5, and he can be a little stinker, right? Any parents out there, their kids can be a little stinker, right? Like, all kids are like that. Let's be honest, right? And so when my son's in that state, or he's gone through like half the day of that, I don't always feel like being grateful for him. Let's be honest here, right? Like, that's one thing you'll find with me. I'm gonna be totally transparent here. But what I do, there's moments where I have to use contrast, and that is, I may sit there and say, what if, God forbid, something happened to him? He was no longer here. There was a little boy that in our neighbor community, they lost a little boy in their back pond. He drowned. No one had an eye on him. They thought they were, one boy, a parent thought he was with the grandparents thought he was with the parents, and he drowned, and it was a shame. And our whole community grieved, but it was a magical experience to see that everyone come together and show love and support. But I use something like that to be like, man, I really can be grateful for my boy, right? Even however he's showing up, I'm like, at least I got him. At least there's breath in his body, right? Like that allows me to tap in and go deep. So you may need to use contrast. You know, 50 Cent, the famous rapper, said, joy wouldn't feel so good if it wasn't for pain. And most of the people today, they don't have contrast, right? Like kids are growing up with cell phones and internet at their fingertips, right? But no one remembers back in AOL days when you had to have that dial up and you had to wait 10 minutes to jump online, right? Like that's contrast. A lot of us, we appreciate gratitude who've been through AOL, right? And so what can you use as contrast? And it's simple, just use the opposite, but go extreme, right? Go extreme there. Contrast is so powerful. And that, for 80% of people, contrast helps them get right into it. So contrast is the second point. The third point is you start big and go small. What do I mean by that? Well, we're always going to start with what we're grateful for, like the big things. I'm grateful that I have a roof over my head. I'm grateful for my wife and children. I'm grateful for my career. I'm grateful that I have food, right? Like we talk about these big things, right, when we're grateful. But one of the things that I would encourage you to do is do what me and my wife do. We go on gratitude walks. And gratitude walks is one person just says what they're grateful for and why. And then the next person, and then you bounce back and forth. And after about, you know, 5 or maybe 10 minutes max, you're running out of big things to be grateful for and you gotta go micro. And that allows you to tap into the gratitude a little bit more, right? Like I can be grateful for my wife and my boys and my home and all that, but if I was doing a gratitude walk with my wife, I might be like 30 minutes in and be like, oh, what am I grateful for? Oh yeah. I remember the time when I was like 6 or 7 and I was going to step on a train track that was electric, right? And it would have zapped me to death. And my stepdad's friend at the time, he yelled my name right before I was about to step on it. And he said, Joe! And I looked and it stopped. And they ran up to me and grabbed me. I can be grateful for that moment, that I'm still alive today. It's like, you know, God was looking out for me in that moment. And I'm grateful for that. Right? There's times where I'm grateful for the things that haven't happened to me or the things that I didn't see that I was protected from. You can get so creative with gratitude, but you gotta be willing to go from the macro to the micro. And the more micro you get, the more you'll experience that gratitude. So those are the three simple steps, right? Gratitude is such a high vibration emotion that you want to get there as much as possible, right? It makes you feel rich. It makes you feel alive. You want to give back more. Plus, when you're grateful, you can't be fearful, right? A lot of times in our life, we have these big decisions to make. You know, should we move here? Should we stay? Should I start my own business? Should I not? Should I invest in this? Should I not invest in this? And we can get into that state of fear, but what breaks us is if we can go into our heart and get into a place of gratitude, because your nervous system can't be grateful and fearful at the same time. And so when you can tap into gratitude, you can make a more powerful decision because you're at a higher vibration, right? So why is it important for us to experience gratitude, right? We know what we need to do and how we can get into it, right? But why do we need to do it? In positive psychology, they came out with an article that shared 14 tips on why it's important to experience gratitude. So I'm going to read them here for you. So I'm going to rapid fire them. Increase happiness in a positive mood. More satisfaction in life. Less materialistic. That's a big one in our world today. So many of us are, you know, do I have the newest cell phone? Do I have a Tesla? How big's my house? How much money do I have, right? What kind of clothes do I wear? I'm like a t-shirt and Ross shoe type guy, right? Like, come on. I don't need a lot of fancy clothes to show off or anything like that. So less materialistic, less likely to experience burnout. For all my entrepreneurs, this is huge. This is why I ask them, what are you grateful for? Because they experience burnout. So it prevents burnout. Better physical health. You sleep better. You have less fatigue. Let's see, lower levels of cellular inflammation. Inflammation's huge. for disease, greater resiliency, which a lot of us need in today's time, especially with where the world is in the state that we're in. And then lastly, encourages the development of patience, humility, and wisdom. And this is all for an individual. But they also went on to talk about a couple for groups, which is increase pro-social behaviors, strengthens relationships, may help employee effectiveness, and may increase job satisfaction. So if you're one of those entrepreneurs out there that employs people, you may want to inject some psychology, which you need to do that also, but you may want to inject some gratitude. So what can you do with this? Well, first off, what I will say is I challenge you to have a gratitude practice. Yes, have a gratitude practice, do it with your partner, do it by yourself, but make sure you include why. See, I have a great client of mine. He's been working with me for about 8 years now, and he's a phenomenal individual. But I love this one thing that he does, and from time to time, he'll reach out and just share why he's grateful for me and our coaching, but he never does it without telling me why specifically. And I'll tell you, when I hear why, when someone says, man, I appreciate all the help you've helped me break through this year and everything you've done for me, that's great. But if they tell you why specifically, it hits a different spot. So I never tell my boys or my wife why I'm grateful for them without telling them why, right? And so I always say, I'm grateful for you because, or here's why. And that speaks so much. When I go into my gratitude practice that I just challenged you on, sometimes people pop into my head and I'll just go with it. I'll say, you know what? You know, my buddy, I remember my buddy Jim, he said, you know, he did this or he did that growing up, and I just appreciate that and I appreciate his friendship. And I might be like, you know what, why not tell him? Share that with him. So I quickly grab my phone and I text him and I say, hey man, just want to share. Do you remember when we were younger, this happened? I just want to say I appreciate you. Because of that, our friendship grew, or this showed up, or this happened to me, or I learned this lesson. Being able to express that, even if you don't do it face-to-face, even in a letter or text message, I prefer voice message over texting, but the more personal you can make it, the better, okay? So that's the first challenge. The second one is, there's a great book called The Magic, and I highly encourage you guys to get it. If you want a 30-day challenge around gratitude, this book is phenomenal for it. I'll put a link in the comments below and in the description below. Make sure you get that book. If you're really looking to tap in, then you're gonna wanna experience this book and what it has to offer. And it's really simple. They give you a lesson and then you have to action take. And I love that. And the first time I did it, I had great, profound breakthroughs in my life. And it's weird. I found that over the years, what happens is when you're more grateful, more comes back to you. It's like God, the universe, this higher power, whatever you want to call it, it's going to give back to you. Because I think of it like me and my son. If my son was throwing a fit on what he didn't have, where he didn't live, what toys weren't in his life, you know, I'd be like, you little brat, right? Like, well, come on, be grateful for what you have. There's people with less. The power of contrast, right? But imagine he comes up to me and says, Daddy, you know what? I really love all my puzzles. I love my dinosaurs. I love all my toys, Daddy. I love my bed. I'm gonna be like, man, that's so awesome, bud. It makes me feel good. Guess what? I wanna give more to you. And whatever you wanna call it, God, universe, higher power, whatever, right? Think about it. If you're always complaining versus actually being grateful, you're probably going to attract more. Plus, if we talk about law of attraction, you don't attract things on a lower vibration. You attract them on a higher vibration, right? And so the seed you sow is what you reap. So I highly encourage you to have a gratitude practice, to get this book, The Magic, because it is powerful. It's a step-by-step guide. I gave you those three simple steps that allow me and my clients to be able to have success and experience gratitude and going deeper. And I'll be honest, there's been some magical things that have happened in my life. And I'm telling you, from the house that I have, to the woman I met, to my boys, that comes not from just execution, which is part of it, but I was giving gratitude for all of this years before I met my wife, had my children, or built this house. So give gratitude now for what you want to experience in the future. And that's a key. And if I was you, I'd write that down. All right, guys, if you're grateful for this video, hit that subscribe button, like this video, give it a thumbs up, comment below. What are you grateful for? What's one to three things in your life that you're grateful for and why? Share that with us below. We want to know what that is. If this is valuable for you, share it with someone who needs it. You know, maybe it's one of those grumpy people who haven't been grateful in a long time. Share it with them and tell them that they must watch this. So with that, look forward to seeing you guys on the next video. My name is Joe Moffitt with Master Life by Design. See ya.